Welcome to day four of our virtual VBS, Concrete and Cranes. I'm Miss Jenny.
And I'm Miss Tanya.
We hope you have had fun this week. We know this isn't what our normal VBS looks like, but we believe God is going to use it for great work. Remember to give us your full attention when you watch our videos so you can learn what God wants you to learn. We have two more days of fun planned. Get ready to see some of your favorite people. Don't forget to dig in your bucket again today. It has some great goodies inside to go along with our video. If you don't have a bucket and you're just watching, that's okay too.
Our goal this week is still to have fun and build a strong foundation on Jesus. Jesus is God's son, and remember, he loves you so much. We are going to continue to build on our knowledge of Jesus and uncover the truth that he who began a good work on you is going to carry it on to completion. Let's say our VBS motto again.
Jesus, our strong foundation.
Say it with us.
Jesus, our strong foundation.
Great job, y'all. Now it's time to go see Miss Becca and dance the theme song.
What's in your belt, Crystal?
Guess.
Wait, don't tell me. I know. You have more names for our friends who we're here today?
That's true, but I also have something else.
Do you have that little bird that had the brick on its wing that you set free to fly away into the bright blue sky? The little bird come back to thank you?
No, I still haven't seen that bird. Have you? Me neither, but have you seen one of these?
What is that?
Do you know how to use it?
No.
So?
Wasn't that a job description?
Nail.
Oh, now I see. Thank you for explaining that. See, you learn something new every day.
We've been learning all kinds of things as we've moved around the concrete and crane sites. Jesus chose to love me, and I can't earn it.
Jesus loves me regardless of my sin.
Jesus chose to die for me.
All of this reminds me that we are still building on the love of Jesus.
That's important to remember. But you know what we almost forgot?
We've forgotten something? Oh, right. Let's see who's here today. We've got Abby. Whoop, whoop. Abby. Woo. Yes. Jeremiah. Hi, Jeremiah. Woo. Whoop, whoop. Whoop. Crystal, what else do you have in your hat?
That's it, Connor. Nothing else. So I guess I should put it on since we'll be going out on site again.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to another great day on the building site. Are you going to bring your new tool with you?
If I can remember, I'll bring it and try to use it to help the work crew before the end of the day.
While you're at it, see if you can remember our bonus verse before the end of the day. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. Matthew 28:20.
There are lots of great things for us to do today. We're glad you're here to share them all with us.
Have a fun day. Be careful out there. And we'll see you again soon.
Hey, kids. Welcome to day 4 of our virtual VBS Bible study. And we've been learning some great things about Jesus' love, haven't we? And you know, every day as I think more about Jesus' love, I get more and more excited. Don't you? It's such a wonderful, wonderful thing. We've been talking about the love of Jesus and the forgiveness of Jesus and what we're worth to Jesus. And today we're going to keep building on our understanding of his love today. Remember our toolkit? Remember our most important tool to learn about Jesus' love? It is the Bible, B-I-B-L-E, the Bible, the Word of God. And we're going to be looking at the Bible today again. Do you remember some of our other tools? Remember when we talked about Paul? There was a bright light, like a flashlight. And we have a flashlight in our toolkit, right? You remember how the light shone down and the Lord spoke to Paul and forgave him of all the mean things that he'd done? And then let Paul be a light to shine Jesus' love for everybody else to see. Remember last time we used a whistle. We talked about how Jesus was in the garden and praying and that some of his friends fell asleep and he wanted them to wake up and understand what he was doing for them. We talked about how Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And you know, sometimes I think I need to hear a whistle to remind me to wake up and remember what Jesus did on the cross for us. Well, I've got something else in our toolbox today, and that's in this little bag. Let me open it up. It is, can you see it? What do you think that is? It's a nail. Those are nails. So that has a very important part in our study for today. You know, our study for today in God's Word involves emotions. Do you have emotions? I think you do. We all have emotions. Let me mention a couple emotions. Have you ever been sad? I've been sad. I'll tell you what, can you do this like you're crying? When I say the word sad, sad. Ever been sad? I've been sad. You know, another emotion is scared. You know what sometimes I would do when I was scared? I'd hide my face in my hands like that. I was scared. And sometimes I was excited. And you know what I would do when I was excited? Sometimes my hand would just go like this, and I'd be so excited. And then sometimes I would feel like I wanted to worship. And sometimes I bow my head and worship like that. As I read this story, what I want you to do is make the symbols for the emotions we talk about. Let's go over them again. Sad, right? Scared, excited, worship. Amen. So let's go over this story. I love this story. Last time we talked about how Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And our story takes place after that. After Jesus died on the cross, they took his body down and put it in a cave. And they rolled a big stone in front of it. And that's where our story begins. It's in Matthew chapter 28. So let's look at the best tool that we have for learning about God's love and read it together. So 3 days after they took Jesus' body down and laid it in the cave and rolled a big stone in front of it, two ladies, both named Mary, they both had the same name came to where they put Jesus' body, and there was a severe earthquake. What emotion do you think went with that? Fear.
I think afraid, right? I'd be afraid.
They were afraid. Because an angel had come. An angel had come and had caused the earthquake and rolled away the stone that was in front of the cave where they put Jesus' body. How do you think they felt about that? Maybe they were afraid, and maybe they were excited. Right? I think I would have been too. And the angel was sitting on the great big stone that he had rolled away. And the Bible tells us what he looked like. The angel shining like lightning. Have you ever seen lightning? The angel was shining like that. And his clothes were as white as snow. There were Roman soldiers. They're big, tough Roman soldiers. And they were so afraid that they fainted. How do you think they felt?
They were afraid. They were afraid.
They fainted. The angel spoke to the ladies and said, "Don't be afraid. I know that you're looking for Jesus who died on the cross. Jesus isn't here. He's alive again, just as he said he would be. Come see the place where they put his body." How do you think they were feeling? Maybe a little afraid. Maybe they were a little excited, right? Maybe also worshiping. But so they went and looked at where they had placed Jesus' body, and guess what? He wasn't there. He wasn't there. And the angel said, "Go and tell his followers, his friends, that Jesus is alive, and he'll meet them in Galilee." And how do you think they felt? Excited. I think they felt excited to go and tell the good news that Jesus was alive. He wasn't dead anymore. Amen. So the two Marys ran from there, and on their way to tell Jesus' friends that he was alive, guess what happened? You will listen. This is unbelievable, but it's true. They saw Jesus himself. Jesus himself. How do you think they felt? The Bible says they fell down and they worshiped him. And they were worshiping Jesus. Jesus told them to go and tell his followers to meet him in Galilee. And I think they were excited. I think they were so happy to go and tell the good news, ready to share. Well, they did that. They went and told Jesus' friends, his followers, that Jesus was going to meet them in Galilee. And when all his friends got to Galilee, to the place where Jesus told them to meet, guess what happened? They saw Jesus. And they worshiped him. What did they feel? They worshiped him. Amen. And Jesus spoke to them. And he said, "Go and tell everybody about me and help them to follow me. And as you go, I will be with you always, even to the end of the earth." How do you think they felt? I think they were excited. And maybe worshiping, maybe a little even afraid. All these different emotions that they felt. They were real people like you and me. You know, today it's really important for us to understand something. Jesus loves you. And he died on the cross so that all the things that you've ever done or would ever do to make God sad can be forgiven. And because he's done that, you can go and tell for them. Isn't that great? And if we'll do that, Jesus made a promise. And that's our word for today. Promise. And listen to the promise. Jesus says, "I'm never going to leave you. You'll never be alone. I'm going to be with you even to the end of all things. Always and forever." That's Jesus' promise to you. Isn't that a great promise? Jesus is going to be with us in everything that we do for him. I love that story because it's true. It's true. Amen. So some of the words that we're learning is love and forgiveness and worth and promise. Promise. Well, that's kind of what our verse is about this week, and we're doing well. By the way, you're doing better every day. Congratulations, you're doing a great job. Let's learn a little bit more. I am sure of this, say it after me, I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion, will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus, until the day of Christ Jesus, Philippians 1:6. Right? One more time? Okay. I'm sure of this, I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion, will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus, until the day of Christ Jesus, Philippians 1:6. You're doing such a great job. Isn't it great to see how we're building on the foundation of the love of Jesus each and every day? We learned of his love, and we learned of his forgiveness. Then we learned of what we are worth to him. And today we learned of his promise to be with us and love us forever. Isn't it great? Well, we have a little bit more to add tomorrow. So come back tomorrow, and we'll have another Bible story time. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving us so, so much that you died on the cross for our sins. Thank you for letting them put those nails in your hands and your feet and nail you to a cross to die there for the things that we did to make God sad. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to go and tell other people about how much you love them too. Thank you, Lord, that as we go, you'll be with us forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thanks for being here today for our Bible story time, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Hey guys, it's Becca, Bethany, and Leanne, and today we're teaching you day 4.
When I feel afraid, like walls are gonna cave around me, I think about the way your love and grace and peace have found me. Remember what you said, you will never ever leave me. So I'm holding on to all your promises. I build my life on you, on the strength of your love and your mercy and truth. On this rock I stand, not on
on the strength of your love.
What a fun-filled day.
Man, you could say that again.
What a fun-filled day.
This was a great day on the site, on concrete and cranes.
Did I say that it was a fun-filled day?
Yes, you did. You said it twice. Did you find a way to use your new tool?
You know I didn't, Connor, but I did find a great new tool to help me build on the foundation of promise we learned about today.
What tool is that?
The Bible, God's Word. The Bible tells me that Jesus will always love me.
The truth that Jesus will always love you is great news to know.
I'm looking forward to tomorrow.
I am too.
Thanks for joining us for day 4 of VBS. You guys have done so great dancing and singing and listening. From our Bible story today, we know that Jesus died on the cross because of his love for everyone. The good news is Jesus didn't stay dead. He came back to life. Jesus is alive. Today's point, Jesus will always love me.
That's right. Jesus promises to never leave us, and he promises that he will always love us. Don't forget to do your activity pages and your crafts for today. We love seeing them on our Facebook page. Be sure to continue to post pictures on that. We hope y'all have a wonderful day, and we'll see y'all back tomorrow for our last day of VBS, day 5. Bye. Bye.